Welcome back. We're so happy to be on Cube 57. This is our premiere on Cube 57. I'm Dr. Laura Murillo, President and CEO of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and we're back with our second guest today, and that is Mark Montgomery. He's the CEO here in Houston for BBVA Compass, a board member of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, and we're going to get back and learn a little bit more about his career in banking and how he became CEO. Well, Mark, some great stories about your bank and all of the great things that you guys are doing at BBVA Compass, but I'm sure it was no easy feat working in banking to ultimately become CEO. So for folks who are watching, you know, my question is, did you always know you wanted to be in banking, and did you ever dream that you'd run such a large international bank?
That's a great question. You know, I did want to be in banking. My father was a banker. He ran First City's Trust Division for years and years when we moved to Houston in 73 till about 86. So I knew that banking is something I wanted to do, and I was always good with numbers.
Yes.
But I didn't know the difference between trust and commercial banking and personal banking, et cetera.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That all that came through a training program at Allied Bank back in the day.
Yeah. So growing up, were you always good at math in school? And what were you like as a high schooler, middle schooler, Mark?
Well, so you asked the math question, and there were two incidents in my life where I really was not so good in math. And I think one of them was third grade, and I just couldn't get this multiplication thing down. And so I had to stay after school and learn it. I was trying to do it my own way, not the way they were teaching me, which I learned that there's rules.
Yeah.
And then in eighth grade, I just Algebra 1 just ate my lunch. And so I had to go to summer school and take that one over again.
Yeah, but here you are. So you overcame that math challenge. And for folks who are watching us, I think a lot of times we let that one setback sometimes define what we can do and can't do. And surely in your career, there have been times when you've had some setbacks. How have you overcome those setbacks, and what's kept you going?
Well, I have a strong faith that keeps me going in the setbacks, and they will come. I mean, everybody has a setback. Things may not go the way we want them to go. You know, someone was telling me that the other day that if you're thinking about the past a lot, you may have regret. If you're thinking about the future a lot, you may be anxious, so you need to be living in the present, certainly taking the lessons from the past, but moving forward in the present.
So we have a lot of folks who are in college, and they're getting prepared and trying to get into that job market. What advice do you have as someone who hires a lot of people? What advice do you have for them?
Great question. Well, certainly a four-year degree would be great. If you're going to get into banking specifically, I would say take plenty of accounting so that you can know it better than most, so that you can come across as thinking on your feet and knowing the numbers better than most people do, particularly the clients that you serve. They know them really well, but if you can go toe-to-toe with them, you'll have an advantage. But I would ask for a mentor or two, some folks that you can talk to and bounce things off of, just so that you can set the stage for the success that you're looking for.
So today in your career as CEO, do you still have that mentor, someone you call when you're having a rough day or you're thinking about something? Are there still people that you call today?
Absolutely. There's two or three people that I just pick up the phone and call and say, what do you think about this?
Yeah.
You know, in the heat of the moment, you may be off a little bit, and you may be frustrated with somebody, et cetera. You need to,
calm down,
you know, get a good night's sleep.
I can't imagine you not calm, Mark. You're
calm
person.
You know, it's not often, but sometimes things will frustrate you. And, and people see that.
Yeah. Well, and it's not easy managing, you know, the work that you're doing, but you're out in the community a lot, and you don't necessarily have to be, but you've chosen to be. What are some of your favorite things that you're doing out in the community?
Well, I love Project Grad. Yeah. That's just been a huge a blessing to be involved with those kids whose parents may not have gone to college, but the kids have a desire to go. They just don't know where to start.
Mm-hmm.
Where are they going to be in 20 years? Yeah. I can't wait to see,
You
know, to have an impact in helping someone else grow personally and achieve their personal goals.
Yeah,
that's pretty cool.
Well, absolutely. And they've been doing a great job for many, many years, and glad that you were there. But you have your own children, and for you, I'm sure that there's things that you want and have tried to instill in them. What are two or three things that you'd love for your children to always have instilled?
Just integrity and treating others with respect. You know, it doesn't matter who the person is. You got to treat them with respect regardless. You know, we all come with certain biases because of experiences that we've had, but that doesn't mean that that new person you met is exactly like someone else that you may think is familiar, you know, from a situation in the past. Mm-hmm. So treat everyone with respect, treat them like you want to be treated, and go from there.
Very good. Well, Mark Montgomery, thank you for serving on the board of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. I can't believe it's been 5 years already.
I know.
You guys have been great to us, and we've enjoyed the relationship, the partnership, and thank you most of all for being on our very first program here on Cube 57.
Well, I'm honored. Thank you for having me.
Well, on behalf of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce, we thank you for joining us today. Hope you've enjoyed our guests, Paul Murphy and Mark Montgomery. I'm Dr. Laura Murillo, President and CEO of the Houston Hispanic Chamber of Commerce. Thank you.